Please be seated, everyone. Professor Murray Wilson, Chief Academic Services Officer, Senior Management and Staff of the University, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. As Deputy Chancellor of the University of South Australia, I'm delighted to welcome you to this graduation ceremony. At the outset, I acknowledge that the ceremony is taking place on Kaurna land. The Kaurna people have performed ceremonies on this land for many centuries, and we pay respect to their living culture and the unique role that they continue to play in the life of the Adelaide region. Let me be the first to officially congratulate you on being here today and on getting your degree, for overcoming all the obstacles that life has thrust at you to receive it here on this day and in this place. After all your hard work, you now face a future like few others have before you. It's a future with some challenges, but some extraordinary possibilities. But you've been prepared well. You have proven to be adaptive, responsive, and flexible. And if you've chosen a career that you're passionate about, truly amazing things will happen, because you'll find that hard work isn't hard work at all. The past year has taught us many lessons, but it has given us all a renewed sense of community and an opportunity to display the kindness, compassion and sensitivity that we're all capable of. Many of you have already demonstrated how strong and resilient and open to possibilities you are as you quickly and easily moved your studies and your work online in the face of the public health emergency. That's the sort of resilience that employers look for. Proof that you can and will adapt to changing circumstances. Proof that learning is so important to you that you continue to learn under any circumstances. Proof that your attitude and work ethic gives you the freedom to work independently. And proof that you'll let nothing stand in the way of achieving what you set out to achieve. I would add to that, the soft skills that you bring to your new career environment will make all the difference. How we deal with challenges, how we support others to deal with challenges, make us who we are. We all have a duty to look out for our colleagues and treat them well, because that is what people remember. I'm certain one of the keys to the success that has led you here today has been the love, support and encouragement of those closest to you, your family and your friends. I'm sure you are all aware, as am I, that without this support you would not be here today. So to demonstrate your appreciation and to thank your family and friends for their invaluable contribution, I ask you to stand up and face your loved ones and give them a big round of applause and a big cheer. Thank you very much, graduates. It's now my pleasure to ask our Chief Academic Services Officer, Professor Murray Wilson, to address you.
Good afternoon and welcome to your graduation ceremony. Congratulations on being here. We know you've worked long and hard to finish your degrees, and that graduations are an important part of your passage into the next stage of your lives. And so we all sit here, sanitized, still, physically distanced, still, and ready to give you the appropriate celebration and send-off. You are different people now. The world you knew as you began your degrees has changed, and so have you. During the years of your degree, we have all developed new ways of being. For a while there, we had just one aim in mind, to protect ourselves and each other from possible harm. But there is more to living and being. From the travails of 2020, from bushfires, lockdowns, and other responses to the pandemic and its effects, we've learned some important lessons. I hope these endure within each of us and within our society. We have learned to value help and support that we both give and receive. We've learned to be agile, to be creative, to sidestep obstacles, and to build better solutions. We've had some time to pause, to think, to reflect, and to contemplate the person we want to be and the place we want to take in the world. Not surprisingly, our learning has often arisen in the context of setbacks and losses. But we're rapidly making our way back to living in what some term the new normal. And here, today, you take another step into that transformed way of working and being. This is the day we congratulate you and wish you well as you begin your future careers. This is the day that makes all the difference. It's the day of our shared success, yours in receiving the parchment you have worked so hard to get, and ours, collectively, for steering you through the past few years, passing on the knowledge you need, and then ensuring that you can practice your craft capably as you pursue your dreams and your aspirations. This year marks our 30th anniversary of shared successes for the hundreds of thousands of students who have crossed the stage. And one aspect remains true of every graduation ceremony. Graduates, like you, taking fresh new credentials and enormous hope into a world alive with possibilities. For 30 years, those graduates have been the innovators, enterprising professionals, and critical contributors who power our economy and shape our world. They are the people whom you will join in the months and years ahead to do your part in pursuing your dreams and advancing your society and your community. Together, I cannot think of a group of people more able to rise to the challenges ahead than the group gathered here today. You have not only been given a solid base on which to build your future career, but you now have the added ability to turn obstacles into opportunities. Each of you has a history with challenges and travail, and things that you cherish have been broken and lost along the way. Remember, now and as you live your life, that there are many beautiful things that arise when things are a bit broken. I am a quilter. I take old cloth, often torn but full of memories, and make quilts that are held together by sewing and embroidery. They're both beautiful and useful. Broken tiles and plates become mosaics in many cultures, or in Japan may take on new life bound together with precious metal in an art form known as kintsugi, or golden repair. Repair, you see, is the essence of resilience. Our bumps and breaks, our setbacks and losses, strengthen our resolve and lead us to savor success all the more. In Leonard Cohen's anthem, he wrote, "There is a crack in everything. That's how the light gets in." Through our unique experiences, we are able to leverage our resilience and what we have learned to craft a better future for ourselves, for our families, and for our world. That's how the light gets in. As you cross the stage today, hear your name and every clap and cheer as affirmation of your achievements and of your future. I ask that each of you enjoy the light. On behalf of the University of South Australia, I wish each of you every success, every joy, and great fortune for the years to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Wilson. I now invite Professor Craig Williams, Dean of Programs, Pharmacy and Biomedical Sciences, UniSA Clinical and Health Sciences, to begin the presentation of awards.
Deputy Chancellor, I present to you the candidate for the Ian Davey Research Thesis Prize, adjudged the Best Doctor of Philosophy Thesis in 2020. Based on the quality of examiner's reports, the candidate's publication record, and the potential community impact of the thesis. Deputy Chancellor, I present the winner of the Ian Davey Research Thesis Prize, Dr. Hayley Beth Schultz, for thesis title. Supersaturated silicolipid hybrids, overcoming the challenges of oral drug delivery. Deputy Chancellor, I present to you the candidates who have fulfilled the conditions for admissions to awards of this university. And I request that awards be conferred in absentia upon the other candidates whose names appear in the graduation ceremony handbook.
Professor Williams, I have pleasure in conferring awards on all candidates who have complied with the prescribed requirements.
For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Parinaz Ahangar. For thesis entitled, Development of Stem Cell Therapies for the Treatment of Wounds. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Ahangar. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Abel Tesfaye and Shabo, by thesis entitled, Novel Cyclin-Dependent Kinase 9 Inhibitors for the Treatment of Cancer, Identification and Preclinical Evaluation. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Anshaba. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Melissa Kelly Bennett, by thesis entitled Targeting Sphingolipid Metabolism in Proteasome Inhibitor-Resistant Multiple Myeloma. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Bennett. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Wen Chen Chai, by thesis entitled Targeting Bacteriocellular Division via FDSZ as an Approach in the Development of New Antimicrobial Agents. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Chai. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Patrick Luke Faulkner, by thesis entitled Exercise-Induced Fatigue and Corticomotor Neural Excitability in Individuals with a History of Illicit Drug Use. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Faulkner. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Maxine K. Freeman Robinson, by thesis entitled How do governments manage uncertainty about pharmaceutical evidence while maintaining a transparent and rigorous decision-making process for public reimbursement of pharmaceuticals? Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Freeman Robinson. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Mitra Javanmard, by thesis entitled Transition Experiences of Internationally Qualified Midwives Practicing Midwifery in Australia, a Mixed Methods Study. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Javanmard. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Sajid Esadat Maghribi, by thesis entitled Polymer lipid hybrid microparticles enhance the intracellular uptake and activity of rifampicin against bacterially infected macrophages. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Maghribi. degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Nashua Masnoon, by thesis entitled Multimorbidity, Polypharmacy, and the Identification of Patients at High Risk of Adverse Medicine Events. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Masnoon. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Christopher Francis Patterson, by thesis entitled Situated Knowledge of the Client's Experience, an Ethnography of Involuntary Admission Decision. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Patterson. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Imogen Jane Ramsey, by thesis entitled Core Patient-Reported Outcomes for Monitoring Cancer Survivorship at a Population Level. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Ramsey. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Nina Anastasia Wilson, by thesis entitled Dietary and Sociodemographic Determinants of Maternal Omega-3 Fatty Acid Status in Pregnancy. Deputy Chancellor, I present Dr. Wilson. For the degree of Master of Health Services Management, Karishma Kushwaha. And Jing Miao. For the degree of Master of Nursing, Nurse Practitioner, Ella Gagolkina. And Rebecca Margaret Sertori. For the Graduate Diploma in Health Services Management, Avisak Bhattacharjee. The Graduate Diploma in Mental Health Nursing, Shahzad Kayam Ali. Salem Bamanzara. Shweta Chadha. Suliang Cheng. Sophia Arena Chekovich. Lisa Damala. Diana Diminich. Sarah Jane Gorham. Kaori Honjo. Gurpreet Kaur. Tariq Hussein Malik. Mizanur Rahman. Manjari Rajapadaya. Pulahinge Wasanti Hemamali Rodrigo. Anita Shrestha. Amy Lee Taylor. Vishevjit Vishevjit. Leah Wanjiku Chege. And Mi Wong. Graduate Certificate in Surgical Pathology Preparation, Lyndon Joshua Macaraig Fennell. For the degrees of Bachelor of Pharmaceutical Science and Bachelor of Pharmacy Honours, Emily Luana Costanzo. Lauren Kate Daniel. Joshua Vincent Maxwell. And Melina Rozovsky. For the degree of Bachelor of Biomedical Research Honours, Daniel Alexander Bishop. Cameron James Dutchkey. Ryan Mark Jakowski. Ashdeep Kaur. Cohen John Kosh. Sakti Katambari Lennon. Nathaniel Peter Napoli. Ryan Daniel Norton. And Harriet Warren. For the degree of Bachelor of Pharmacy Honours, Sarah Al-Samawi. Hannah Amar. Lauren Grace Anderson. Chrysanti Angelikos. Eliza Grace Baker. Huri Balakubiri. Scott Bates. Concertina Blafari. Samuel Michael Bode. Ellen Kate Bull. Christina Capozzi. Kushum Chapagai. Gahao Cho. Jacinta Cristiano. Michaela Dillon. Zainab A.F. Fatah. Emily Frost. Stephanie Gigolas. Meg Gordon. Arabella Rose Hart. Joshua Eduardo Hogman. Chalyam Hu. Veronica Iderola. Lauren Irvine. Yusri Cardo. Sharan Jit Kaur. Zia Kafina. Rose Cogway. Tina Cogway. Calvina Curtin. Andy Lamb. Emma Louise Laudonia. Jisun Lee. Stephanie Louise Lee. Chuk Lin Young. Bowen Liu. Xinyi Liu. Konstantinos Logothetis. Linda Lee. Mary Lynch. Adriano Marchison. Blake Andrew McCallum. Tahira Mohammadi. Joel William Moore. Vanessa Mountain. Lucian Nyker. Farzana Nowrosi. Akash Pala. Marena Parameswaram. Sophie Rose Peacock. Daniel Fung. Kaylee Ann Price. Amelia Janet Sander. Aidan Sapio. Nicholas Lawrence Scarfo. Jordan Seychelles. Paul Siadelis. Monica Sharma. Owen Peter Smith. Stephanie Stadulka. Selena Tang. Putirothsepor Tan. Stamati Theologitis. Tung Tui Han Tran. Sophia Tsouvalos. Gaganpreet Kaur Walia. Kirolas Magdi Yakub. Reza Gul Yaya. Cynthia Yap. Panayoti Peter Zakaria. And Yua Jong. For the degree of Bachelor of Community Health, Katie Lee Bernadette Berryman. Gemma Dalby. Deborah Lee Gregory. And Deborah Margaret Wangari Kariuki. For the degree of Bachelor of Nursing, Luca Dimenich. Deputy Chancellor, this concludes the presentation of awards.
Thank you, Professor Williams. Graduates, you have shared one of the most significant periods of your life with your colleagues at the University of South Australia. You have worked hard and earned a degree from one of the world's best young universities. I know that in whatever your field of expertise, you will make a valuable and lasting contribution to your own communities and take your part in a rapidly growing network of UniSA-inspired success stories, people who are all doing interesting and good work throughout the world. And while on that subject, the subject of UniSA success stories, today we are assembled in the cultural and sporting heart of UniSA, Pridham Hall, where we celebrate all of our successes, including yours today. This building was made possible by a South Australian success story, a man named Andrew Pridham. Andrew is an alumnus of ours who, like you, graduated and went on to make his mark upon the world, first in property management and then in merchant banking, before he came back to contribute to UniSA's vision for the future. So strong was Andrew's connection to the university and his belief in how it enabled him and his success that he made the single largest philanthropic donation to UniSA, which was used to build this magnificent building. Andrew graduated from us with all the attributes that you graduate with today. You have the qualifications, and coupled with the passion to do something positive, you can make real change in the world. I very much hope that you stay in touch with us and let us know what you're up to. You can do this through our alumni network, which now has almost 250,000 members. It's a network that is there to help you, to support you, and to give you that connection back to your university. As you leave today, I wish you a world of opportunity and good fortune. But before you go, please stay seated while the rest of us in this assembly stand to congratulate you and wish you well on your journey.